Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come now and worship the Lord. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come all you people, come and praise your maker. Come now and worship the Lord. Uyai Mose, tina matemwari. Uyai Mose, tina matemwari. Uyai Mose, tina matemwari. Uyai Mose svino. Uyai Mose, tina matemwari.
Good morning, church.
Good morning, church.
Today we begin a new sermon series called Giving Thanks, where we take a look at different passages in Scripture within the Bible that allow us to give thanks for one another. Here at this church, we open our doors to all people,
regardless of race,
gender,
economic status, social status,
or sexual orientation,
because we believe God loves and welcomes all people.
Now let's join together in our opening music.
Tenderly, we are called We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, singing, we are singing, singing, we are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, singing, we are singing, singing, we are singing, for the Lord is our light. Siya hamba kukanyen kwenkos, siya hamba kukanyen kwenkos, siya hamba kukanyen kwenkos, siya hamba kukanyen kwenkos, siya hamba, hamba, siya hamba, hamba, siya hamba kukanyen kwenkos, siya hamba, hamba, siya hamba, hamba, siya hamba. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, singing, we are singing, singing, we are singing, for the Lord is our light. We are singing, singing, we are singing, singing, we are singing, for the Lord is our light.
Oh, that sounded really good. Let's continue with our worship as we join together in our opening prayer.
Lord God, creator of all, in your wisdom you have bound us together so that we must depend on others for the food we eat, the resources we use, the gifts of your creation that bring life, health, and joy. Greater God, we give thanks. Amen.
Amen. Now let's continue worship as we hear a passage from Paul's letter to the Thessalonians.
Today's reading is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 11 to 21. Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing. Now we ask you, brothers, to respect those who work hard among you, who are over you in the Lord, and who admonish you. Hold them in the highest regard in love because of their work. Live in peace with each other, and we urge you, brothers, warn those who are idle, encourage the timid, help the weak, be patient with everyone. Make sure that nobody pays back wrong for wrong, but always try to be kind to each other and to everyone else. Be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Do not put out the Spirit's fire. Do not treat prophecies with contempt. Test everything. Hold on to the good. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
All right, so over the course of these last couple weeks, we've been spending time in conversation with one another. I'm actually going to start calling these conversations about faith, where we invite you to answer a question in the comments below or off to the side that relates to today's sermon. This is an opportunity for us to check in with one another as well as hear how God is acting and reacting with all of us in different ways. So today's question is this. I want you to think of a time when someone said thank you that really knocked your socks off. So let's think about that. And then let us know, what was a time when someone thanked you that it was just so meaningful and it just brought so much joy to your heart? So we'll come back in a couple minutes. We can continue that conversation in the comments below and off to the side.
Thank you.
So I've been caught up in the same news cycle, same checking my phone, same feels like downward spiral with the news. I mean, we're living in difficult times right now where people are protesting for their lives, demonstrating that Black Lives Matter. We're in an election cycle that continues to drum up anger and resentment. So I found myself the other day just looking on the internet, trying to find something that was uplifting and hopeful. And I came across this TED Talk by this Jesuit priest who was talking about gratitude and happiness.
How is the connection between happiness and gratefulness? Many people would say, well, that's very easy. When you are happy, you are grateful. But think again. Is it really the happy people that are grateful? We all know quite a number of people who have everything that it would take to be happy, and they are not happy because they want something else, or they want more of the same. And we all know people who have lots of misfortune. Misfortune that we ourselves would not want to have. And they are deeply happy. They radiate happiness. We are surprised. Why? Because they are grateful. So it is not happiness that makes us grateful. It's gratefulness that makes us happy. If you think it's happiness that makes you grateful, think again. It's gratefulness that makes you happy.
You see, for this priest, he gets to the point of understanding that gratitude is something that evolves from us and it creates joy, creates happiness within us. That when it exudes from us, that when we're constantly giving it out to other people, we find the joy within us. In the passage that we heard this morning, a letter that was written by Paul to the church in Thessalonica. We've hardly ever go to these passages, the theologians. There's two letters that go to them. What it is that they're correspondence. You see, the leaders of one church write Paul and they ask him questions. Now, we don't know what those questions are because that letter is lost to history. But here we find Paul's answers and we can start to put together what was going on within the church. And in Paul's letter today, we see that the church in Thessalonica, the Thessalonians, are doing amazing stuff. And Paul wants to name that. Paul wants the people of this church to know that they are doing important things already. So he lifts them up. He lets them know that they are living like good, faithful people already, and to continue to do it. He goes even further by thanking them for all that they've done. Because he recognizes that it's tough in that time to be people of faith. It's tough to treat one another with respect. It's tough to find the good in somebody else, but they are already doing it, and to continue to do it full-throated. It's a message of gratitude. It's a message of hope and joy. I came across this other video of this well-known scholar. Her name's Brené Brown. If you've not read anything by her and you want to get a little bit more into, you know, what she has to say, I highly recommend her. She's an author and a scholar who writes about emotions and how we as human beings treat one another and what it does to our bodies, what it does to our minds. And in this interview, she goes on to say,
but what I found, you know, 12 years of research, 11,000 pieces of data, I did not interview in all that time a person who would describe themselves as joyful or describe their lives as joyous who did not actively practice gratitude. And for me, it was very counterintuitive because I kind of went into the research thinking that the relationship between joy and gratitude was, if you're joyful, then you should be grateful. But it wasn't that way at all. It was really that practicing gratitude invites joy into our lives. And when I say practice, I think this is the part that really changed my life. It changed my family and the way we live every day. When I say practice gratitude, I don't mean kind of like the attitude of gratitude or feeling grateful. I mean practicing gratitude. These folks shared in common a tangible gratitude practice. They either kept gratitude journals. Some of them did interesting things like at 1, 2, 3, 4, like at 12:34 every day, they said something out loud that they were grateful for. One of the things that we do, like we say grace at dinner. And so now after grace, we go around and everyone in my family says something they're grateful for.
Gratitude is an act. It's something that we do again and again, that when we put it into our daily life, it brings about joy within us. It brings about joy not only within us, but also within others. You see, gratitude is not something that you earn, right? It's usually something that's not expected. It's not something that you can go to the store and buy. It's something that's received. It's something that can come out of the blue. And when it really hits us, when that gratitude really comes out of the blue, it does things within us that excites us, that brings about hope and possibility to do good within this world. Have you ever thanked somebody before and see them be completely shocked by it? Have you ever thanked someone before and shocked them? You see, within this sermon series that we're going to be working on throughout the course of this month, we're going to be talking about thanking others and how we're going to work within ourselves to create gratitude within our bodies, within our voices, and within our souls. Because when we live more fully into thanking other people, we begin to see the light of God in other people. You see, our theology, our belief system doesn't say, oh, I'm just going to let God take care of all of this. No, what God wants us to do, what God needs us to do, like Paul wrote in his letter to the Thessalonians, is to treat one another in a gracious way, so that that spirit of gratitude begins to well up within us and is shared with other people. So this week, I want us to work on something together. I'm going to do it. I'm going to invite my family to do it. And I hope that you would do the same thing. What I'd like for all of us to do is to grab a piece of paper. Grab a pencil or a pen or a marker, something to write down with. And I want you to jot down the name of three people that have done something within your life recently. Could have been within the last 6 months or the last 3 months. Could have been within the last week. Write down those three names. And I want you to find a way to personally thank them. Send them a phone call. Shoot them an email. Or better yet, grab a thank you card and write out to them, thank you for whatever they did for you. And I guarantee that as you start, as you do this throughout the course of this week, as you add gratitude into your daily life, you'll start to find more joy and you'll start to find more happiness. And you'll see that God is at work doing amazing things within this world. Amen. We now transition to a time of prayer. During this time, we're gonna play some music for you. And we invite you to open up your hearts and minds to God, lifting up prayers that are important to you, something that might be deep within your heart that you might be hiding from others, and offering it up to God. We also invite you to drop your prayer concerns in the comments below or off to the side. We'll come back in a few minutes for a time of community prayer, and we'll close out our prayer time this morning with the Lord's Prayer.
Would you join me now in the prayers of the people as we pray for our world, for our country, for our communities, and for those that we love? God of grace and peace, we pray for our world, for environmental crises that have wreaked havoc in the form of hurricanes and wildfires, for places like India, God, where the cases and deaths of COVID-19 have increased at a devastating rate this week. We pray for our country as well, for politicians and leaders whose words stoke the flames of violence and hatred, for people who are committed to engaging with new eyes the roots of racism because they can no longer turn away from its manifestations in our streets, for those who live in states that continue to see more and more new COVID cases every day. We pray, God, for our beloved communities, for our families who are making plans to educate their children at home this fall, and for those families who are making tough decisions to send their children to school, for families facing job eliminations and furloughs, for those who are struggling to pay their bills. For the community helpers, we lift up healthcare, education, sanitation, and service industry workers who are keeping our communities going in these difficult days. For college students who went home this week or who were locked down on their campuses, and for those administrators, God, who are reckoning with having made those choices. For friends and family we long to be with, for anyone who's felt overwhelmed, those battling depression and anxiety, and for anyone who hasn't heard a kind word in a while, God, we pray. And God, since you know a thing or two about the chaos of new beginnings, this week we are sending our New Jersey and New York teachers back to school. They are preparing for what will be an incredibly stressful school year, and we are asking a lot of them. Teach online, teach in person, but maintain distance. Write lesson plans for both, or some combination, just in case. Keep our kids safe. Teach them. Please fix all of the ways we parents have failed them these last 6 months. God, we lift up and pray for our teachers, for these brave frontline workers who are, for those who are scared, for those who have made hard choices, and for those who feel they have no choice. Calm their fears with courage they did not know they had. Cover their faces with masks and shields. Keep their laptops charged and their Zoom rooms secure. Keep them safe from sickness. Remember, help them remember to breathe. God, we pray for your healing in the lives of those who are sick, for Jacob Blake, for Bruno and Barbara, for Jose, for Islin, Robert, Janie, Gail, Vicky, Preeti, Laura Lynn, and George, for Ted and his mom who suffered a stroke. And we remember today the need and the importance to continue to insist that Black Lives Matter. We remember the 187,000 in the United States and the 874,000 throughout the world who are known to have died because of COVID-19. We remember these who we are known now to us, who we lift up by name. I ask that as we conclude this prayer, that you all would join me in praying the Lord's Prayer in whatever language suits that you learned this prayer and that it is significant to you. So please pray with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
And now let's join together in our closing hymn. All right, a couple of quick announcements before we let you go out and enjoy the rest of your Labor Day holiday. Number one, if this has been a great service for you, if this is something that's been fulfilling to you, if you want to share gratitude with others, share this with other people. You know, send them the link, or you know, like everything down below, or give us a comment in the comment sections. This allows us to spread our message to more and more people. So if this is something that's been helpful to you, I guarantee it's going to be helpful for somebody else. So share it if you can. Number two, if you are able to donate to our ministry, we give thanks for that. We give thanks that over these course, these last months, you've found ways in order to grow our ministry in this virtual realm. If you're able to continue to give, we give thanks for that. You can send that to our church, and we'll happily accept those donations. Or you can give online. It's easy, and it's quick, and it's safe. It's something that our family has been doing for the last 8 years, and we invite you to do that as well. You don't even need to be by your computer. It actually can auto-generate each and every week. So if you forget about it, it happens. And finally, each and every Thursday at 7:30, we gather for a time of Bible study. Now, these Bible studies are just a time when we take a look at the scripture, we ask questions, and we go a little bit deeper. No experience needed. And actually, what we're starting to find out in these conversations, in these gatherings online, is that people are willing to go deeper. People are willing to ask difficult questions so that they can understand who God is. Oh, it's been such a wonderful time. But as we go from this place, as we go from this space, may God continue to bless you in all that you do. You know that there is gratitude within your heart. There is gratitude bubbling up within you. There is someone in your life right now who needs to hear the words, thank you. Offer it to them. See how it changes their life. Allow God to work through you to create a more joyful and happy world. And as you go from this place, may God continue to bless you. Do good, create change, and stay humble. In the name of the one who is our creator, our redeemer, and our sustainer. Amen. Go in peace and have a wonderful week.
Let it shine.